Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we will learn how to design a CMOS common source amplifier. In this design problem, the amplifier has an NMOS input stage, M1, and a PMOS active load, M2. The required specifications include the voltage gain, the unity gain frequency, and the input capacitance. It is required to minimize the amplifier power consumption. For M1, the good design strategy will be to use a large GM over ID and a short L. The large GM over ID means biasing in moderate or weak inversion. This will maximize the efficiency and minimize the power consumption. However, increasing the GM over ID too much will violate the input capacitance spec and will increase the parasitics. The short L will help the input capacitance spec. But a very short L may violate the gain spec. For M2, we need to do the exact opposite. M2 is a part of a current mirror circuit. We should use a small GM over ID for strong inversion biasing. This will yield a large output resistance, which is good for gain and for mirroring accuracy. The drawback is the reduced output swing, but it is not a spec in the given design problem. A long L will also improve the output resistance and reduce the mismatch. But a very long L will increase the parasitics and degrade the performance. Next, we should do hand analysis to get a rough estimate for the current that we want to minimize. From the UGF spec, we can calculate the GM of the input stage. Since the GM over ID is a normalized design knob that has a limited search range, we can quickly use it to estimate the bias current. A large bias current will be needed if we use a small GM over ID, and vice versa. Next, we stretch the current search space to rounded nice numbers to account for the ignored second-order effects. We are now ready to start the design process on ADT. Open an empty project. Then, load the LUTs located in the Spectre example folder on Linux or the LTSpice example folder on Windows. Select the NMOS and PMOS LUTs. The LUTs are loaded successfully. Next, go to the Design Database Generation tab. Use the filters to select the properties of the amplifier in the given design problem. It is single stage. It has single-ended input. It has NMOS input stage. It has simple active load. And it has common source topology. For M1, set the max GM over ID to 25 to cover the weak inversion region. For M2, set the min GM over ID to 5 to cover the strong inversion region. Set the current search space as calculated from the hand analysis. In the Corners tab, set the DC output voltage to 0.8 volts. The load capacitance to 500 femtofarads. And the supply voltage to 1.6 volts, as given in the design specifications. Now we will generate a DDB that has 100,000 design points. Browse to save the file to disk. Click Save. The DDB is generated in no time. Now let's go to the Cockpit tab. Add the DDB to the active list. Let's play with the magic sliders. As we apply a constraint on the voltage gain, we can see the minimum possible L and the maximum achievable bandwidth are interactively updated. Set the gain to 50. Similarly, we can explore how all other design specs interact with each other and with the design degrees of freedom. Now, we tune the unity gain frequency. As we change the minimum UGF, the valid GM over ID range and the minimum power consumption are simultaneously changing. Set the UGF to 100 MHz. Now let's pick the design point that has the minimum power consumption. As expected, the input stage is biased towards weak inversion, and the load is biased in strong inversion. However, the gate capacitance spec is violated. Let's apply a constraint on the input capacitance. Set the maximum to 25 femtofarads. the minimum current slightly increased. Again, the new design point matches all our design expectations. And all the specs are now satisfied. We have completed the design successfully. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, send us your feedback, and stay tuned for our coming tutorials. ADT is here to make designers happy.